It's real. Regina, grab it and take it on down.
Bro, would you grab this side so he can explain it and hold it up?
Okay. Cool. So let me just stand right here. Yeah, let's get some help with this. So we can do a history lesson here in the studio. So this is a timeline that my colleague Paul Abina in London, England, and I developed. He was a high school history teacher, right? And so because folk don't really understand and appreciate history because it's not taught right. So what he did was to lay out 8,000 years of history, beginning 5,200 years in the past, going into the present moment, and then 3,000 years into the future, because the whole purpose of the present moment is to connect with the past so that you can create the future. And so we have here a layout of the accomplishments, scientific accomplishments made by African people. So we don't have to make anything up. All we need to do is to do the research. So here we have Nabta Playa, the first astro-archaeological calendar that was developed in Africa, 7,200 B.C., 3,500 years older than Stonehenge. Africans studying the stars, knew that the Earth was round, knew the Earth revolved in this orbit around the sun. We have here Africans building great temples and pyramids. Imhotep built the Step Pyramid, the first building in the world, the Great Pyramids at Giza. We have images. Go from mic to mic. And worry about the headset. Let me take the headset off, if you don't mind. So here we have images, actual images of all the African rulers, kings and rulers, images that were carved during their lifetime, man. So we know, we can see that they're African, even though the noses might be missing or the lips might be missing. We can see that these are African people, and these are the things that they created: writing, agriculture, astronomy, physics, you name it, medicine. Imhotep, the first physician in recorded history. So this is all what we did when we were in control of our destiny, brother, right? And then to give you context, right here, 832 BC is when Homer wrote the Iliad and the Odyssey. The first European book was written thousands of years after Africans had written books and kept them in their libraries and their temples. And then right here we get to 753 BC when Romulus and Remus founded the city of Rome. So right here, this little bitty space right here is the beginning of Greco-Roman history and culture. This is the beginning of white folk culture thousands of years after African culture. So to get to your question and to illustrate it, right here in blue, this little period in blue here, this little small period in blue here, from 1444 to 1888 is the European enslavement of African people. So anytime we begin our history in slavery, we are missing out on all of this documented history, documented success. So that's why I write, man. That's why I teach. That's why I'm excavating, so that we can document this information and put it in print form, come here and talk about it, so we can know the truth and then act on this truth.